That was one black stuntman, and that was Calvin Brown. He double cocked me on I Spy. And even though maybe the trouble that Cosby got himself in, I'm not going there, but the point was, Cosby was the first black actor to say, I will not let any white stuntman be painted down and double him. So Calvin Brown and Eddie Smith started the Black Stuntmen's Association. We couldn't get anyone to train us, so we started training our own selves on 120th and Broadway in L.A. every Wednesday night we would go out. And every Wednesday night, about 15 squad cars from LAPD would show up because they thought that we was militant, we was the Black Panther. And we was training for something ruthless or something until we convinced them who we were. We didn't have mats to fall on. We would fall building our friend garages and all of that stuff until we was able to chip in enough money to get mattresses. Then how we learned how to do all of that stunt driving and wrecking cars, not wrecking cars, but the 180s and all of that stuff. We would pool our money and go rent cars from Hertz. And when Hertz found out what we was doing, they put a stop to that. Then the big fight that came with the motion picture industry came in 1969 or '70. But did any of y'all see Skin Game with Lou Gossett?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm.
That was the big fight. They painted down a white stunt guy to double Lou Gossett when he was driving that wagon down the hill with the runaway slaves in. We had to go to the EEOC. The EEOC gave us a lawyer. Mm-hmm. Also, if we would come in, that would stop them from being painted down with the double James Earl Jones and all of that. We put a stop to all of that in the 70s. And what you see today with Denzel, Tyler Perry and all of that, the black stuntmen filed 32 charges in the early 70s because with no black producers, with no black makeup, hairstylists, wardrobe, behind and in front of the camera, it was done. We changed all of that.
Wow. That's great.
Now I'm retired. I'm the president of the Black Stuntmen's Association. We just came back from Stunton, California, which is on YouTube. Black stuntmen honored in Stockton, California.
Okay.
Also, my first biggest movie, the biggest stunt was Dirty Harry, the first Dirty Harry with Clint Eastwood.
Yes.
Then I did a little few bit parts, but I ain't acting.
It's okay.
The stunts are important.
And see, I just heard about her. But if anybody want to look up our website, Black Stuntmen.
Write it down, everybody.
Are you mind saying this all over again?
It's Black
Stuntmen. No, I mean
from the beginning. He's going to
want to record this.
Yeah,
oh, that's like the first black he used on Gunsmoke was Cicely Tyson. But since then, we have been honored by Congress, the Senate, the state of California, the state of Nevada, and the biggest honor that we got, that I was surprised, the state of Mississippi honored us.
Wow.
I am from Mississippi. Wow. Last matter of fact, it was a year today that the state of Mississippi honored me and my stunt group at the state capitol in Jackson, Mississippi. I stood where the governor stands to make a speech. And it's just like the leader standing on stage and the other senators and assemblymen sitting out here. This is the first time in my life that I ever got a standing ovation from a white group. And I never forgot after that, just before B.B. King died, they interviewed him. He said that he had been around the world, met kings and queens, biggest honor that he had was being from Mississippi, and the state of Mississippi honored him. And I can concur with that, because looking out the window then, I saw all of these oak trees and things. I remember as a kid growing up running from the Klan and all of that, how many blacks that was at home. Because I was the same age Emmett Till was when he got killed in Midas, Mississippi. I remember all of that. I picked cotton, I chop cotton. And you got a couple of kids here. One thing I can say to your kids, that door might be closed to you. But if you got enough knowledge of the kid, ain't no door closed to you. You can open them all. Also be respectable and listen. When you do disrespectful things, people brand you. But I'm outspoken. Someone in my stunt group had to carry their load. I got injured in 1972 on a movie called Top of the Heap. I got kicked in the back and busted two vertebrae in my back and busted my knee. And after that, I became president of the Black Stunt Association. And this is what the big, we got another big honor coming in September. We will be honored at the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C.
Mm-hmm.